All right, we are joined by Dave Vallee. He is head of the Northeast River Forecast Center. And we've got three Linden State College graduates here. Big weather school up there in Vermont, and all three of us went there.
We've known Dave for many, many years. He is a walking encyclopedia when it comes to New England hurricanes.
Dave, tell us a little bit about your job as head of the River Forecast Center.
So for a River Forecast Center, we have the duties of forecasting what comes out of the sky. And then the hydrologic part is figuring out what all that water is going to do when it hits the ground to forecast the rivers and streams, their elevations, the amount of flow. And for hurricanes, as we saw in Irene, it can be all about the rain. Or like we saw in Sandy, it can all be about my ability to forecast that storm surge up the rivers and streams in the region.
So there's the misconception maybe with the public with an approaching hurricane is that if I'm not near the bay or the ocean, I don't have a flood concern, and nothing could be further from the truth. The inland freshwater flooding is the concern.
In fact, by today's standards, that's where many of the deaths are occurring.
Away from the ocean.
Away
too.
From the ocean. It's not the storm surge, it's the fresh water. Just look at New England, Rhode Island and Connecticut. One of the worst events in our history from a river flood standpoint was Hurricane Diane, 1955. Which dumped 18.15 inches of rain in one day over the town of Westfield, Massachusetts. Catastrophic flooding. It put down a foot of rain over the Blackstone Valley, which did a number on the city of Woonsocket at that time. I mean, absolutely devastated that community.
So rivers like the Blackstone, the Patuxent, even some of the smaller rivers, how aggravated they can get, even in a minimal hurricane that maybe slows down, dumps a tremendous amount of rain.
Yeah, and we've had that happen historically, where you get a slower mover, and it's typically the slower movers that are going to be the ones to produce the most rainfall. But even storms like Carol or 1938 that were moving at 40, 50 miles an hour still dumped anywhere from 6 to 8 inches of rain over us.
Dave, what's the worst case scenario from your standpoint as far as freshwater flooding?
Oh,
for us here in New England.
For us here in New England, I think clearly it's a storm system that's going to make landfall over Cape Cod so that we're not so focused on the storm surge. Put Irene going up Buzzards Bay would have put that 10 to 15 inches of rain down over Rhode Island in nearby Massachusetts. That would have been our worst case river flood scenario. But we've got a couple of rivers like the Pawcatuck and the Patuxent where we can drive an 8 or 10 foot storm surge back up those rivers for miles. And people, I think, don't realize that there's that kind of potential, even on the Patuxent, way up the bay, that we could drive a 10-foot storm surge all the way back to the Pontiac Mill.
And it doesn't have to be a hurricane. It can be a remnant moisture from a storm. It can be a tropical storm or even a tropical depression, so not necessarily a hurricane.
No, that's correct. All we really need is the circulation tapping that deep tropical plume of moisture. You get that right combination and it's a slow mover, you're going to have an awful lot of rainfall. And we've seen it happen in June. We've seen it happen in late October, like we did in 2005, where we had three systems that had tropical remnant with them and put down over a foot and a half of rain over parts of central Massachusetts. And that produced very severe flooding down the Blackstone Valley.
All right, what can people do to prepare for that kind of flooding?
You know, I think the first thing is know thy enemy. You've got to understand where you are in the floodplain. Realize the history. If you've had flooding before from lesser storms, understand what it's going to take. You want to make sure you can get everything of critical nature out of the basement, out of the low level. If you're in a floodplain, know where your shelters are. Treat it like the coastal residents do. People who are going to need to evacuate know where those shelters are. They utilize the evacuation maps to their advantage. We need to take the same approach on the rivers and streams. And many times you're not going to be able to see the river that's going to put the water on your property. So just prepare ahead of time. Know what you're going to do and have a plan to do it.
All right, Dave, thanks for the great work that you guys do over at the National Weather Service in Taunton and especially in the River Division and all the important information that you're giving out every day. We appreciate it.
Well, thank you very much. Good to be with you guys.